Okay, so the last one here is, why is there something rather than nothing? And this one, I think the creationists usually say that, where'd everything come from? And, you know, you need God to do that. But then usually the atheist will say, too, well, where did God come from? What do you think about all that?
Well, first of all, how do we even know there is something rather than nothing? Are you convinced that we're here? Are we here?
Yeah, why not?
Okay. How do you know that?
Because I could hear myself talking.
Okay. We have to observe by our senses, sight, taste, you know, touch, etc. We have five senses, five ways to contact the world, I guess, for lack of a better way to say it.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe there are more. Maybe there are 20 senses, and we've only got five of them. You know, blind people certainly are missing one. Deaf people are missing one. But just with the five senses we have, we can say, okay, it appears that we're here. It appears that we're real. But why is there something rather than nothing? I think you said, you know, where did God come from? That question assumes a couple of things. It assumes that God is locked in time, space, matter like we are, and that he had to come from somewhere. And even if I can never figure out where or why or how, that doesn't prove his non-existence. The fact that I can't figure it out or you can't figure it out, we have just 3-pound brains. You know, of course there's things we can't understand. You don't understand what gravity is.
Mm-hmm.
There's a person on the planet that knows what gravity is.
Yeah, I agree. There's a lot of things we don't understand, and our senses are very limited. Like, we don't even know what dark energy is, dark matter. We don't really understand the quantum world. There's a lot of huge mysteries.
Okay, well, therefore, do they not exist, or we just need to keep studying?
Definitely need to, keep on researching.
Same with God. Keep studying. You'll find them.
But the point is, sometimes creationists say, like, well, can you explain how everything came to be? No. Okay, well, God did it. And as far as I'm concerned, that's just magical thinking. It's, you know, people used to say God did everything, and then you find out in science, you know, like God causes earthquakes. No, it was actually plate tectonics. God causes lightning. No, it was actually electrical differences. So...
Well, you're using a faulty argument here. The fact that people in the past have believed stupid things doesn't mean that the whole concept is wrong. I agree. I know. I just think I understand what causes earthquakes. You know, side slip, other slip faults, and strike faults, and different types of fault lines, and how they move and cause earthquakes, and it depends upon the, you know, the S&P waves. And we could talk for 2 hours on that if you'd like. I taught her science 15 years. I think I could give a reasonable explanation for earthquakes, and I don't say God did it. But you have to get back to an initial cause at some point. Where did matter come from? Where did time come from? Where did energy come from? Where did space come from? Do you, as a professed atheist, have an answer to any of those?
No. There's some theories out there, like, where did the Big Bang come from? Nobody knows. Maybe there's a multiverse, but yeah, nobody knows.
Well, you're assuming that there even was a Big Bang. What if there wasn't? I don't know. I'm just asking, you know, it sounds like you're just taking some things on faith. Which is fine. I take a lot of stuff on faith, too.
Well, it's not faith like, oh, I just got an idea. Hey, maybe that's it. Let's believe it. It's like, people say the universe is expanding, and so they say, let's rewind the tape, and that's why it goes back to a Big Bang. It's based on evidence.
Why do you say the universe is expanding? Is that based on the redshift?
Yeah, redshift and blue shift on things that are coming towards us. Redshift, things going away from us.
Well, if there's things coming toward us,
mm-hmm.
Then is it expanding?
No, it's just a direction. If it's, there'll be a blue shift if it's coming your way, and a red shift if it's going away from you.
I understand the theory behind it, the Doppler effect. Is there any evidence of any stars that are blue shifted?
I think so. Like, we're on a collision course with the Andromeda galaxy. So that they're coming, we're coming together. So that should be a blue shift, I think.
I don't know. It's interesting. I have to check that out.
Mm-hmm.
But 17 times in the Bible, it says God stretched out the heavens. Could it be that God created the earth first, like it says in the Bible, and then the stars a couple days later, and stretched them out into place, which would certainly cause a red shift? So if there is a red shift, the Doppler effect of the star receding, that still wouldn't prove there isn't a God or that he didn't stretch it out. You could interpret it as evidence for your theory, i.e. Big Bang, and I can interpret it as evidence for my theory, i.e. God stretching the heavens, the fact is we see a red shift. That's the end of the facts. Everything else is an interpretation of those facts or an induction, not necessarily part of this fact.
Well, let me ask you about this. I mean, you know about the appearance of age argument, right, against young Earth creationism.
Sure. How old was Adam on day one?
Yeah, and especially put to the stars, though. For example, if you see a supernova explosion and they say it was like so many billion light years away from us, and you're saying that no, that was less than 6,000 years ago. Sometimes they say, you know, God created the light in transit or something. So in other words, you're seeing something that never really happened because it didn't actually happen that long ago. I'm trying to understand how do you answer to that one about?
Yeah, I don't make those arguments. I think it's much simpler. God created this earth first, like he said in Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And then later, he's created the stars on day three and stretched them out into their current place. Let's just pick a number and say the stars are moving away at 90% the speed of light. Okay, well, then Adam and Eve would see the taillights as they're moving away. They would see them their first day on earth, their first night, and everybody would see them ever since then. And the stars could indeed be billions of light years away. I don't know. Nobody does. You cannot measure star distance beyond about 100 light years.
Mm-hmm. So if you do see something blue shifted, that would kind of throw that out of whack, you're saying, because you're assuming everything is moving away from us, and if there are stars coming at us, then that kind of
I don't know. I'd like to see more evidence on that. But if God stretched out the heavens, and certainly the galaxies seem to be spiraling around each other, not only spiraling around themselves, but there seems to be a big galactic dance, I guess, of all the galaxies. So that would certainly cause some of the stars to be coming toward us. Mm-hmm. Just the fact that a galaxy is spinning, let's say it's, you know, 1,000 light years away and it's spinning, well, one side of it is turning toward us and one side's turning away, like any merry-go-round would do. So no, you could still have a blue shift. I've not seen evidence of any blue shift. I'm not saying there isn't any, but let's just assume, okay, look, that still, I think, is explainable easily with God stretching out the heavens like he said he did.
Well, I heard we're certainly on a collision course with another galaxy. Have you heard of that one?
No. What are you going to do when it happens?
I mean, it's I don't know, many billions of years from now, but, you know, the Earth may even be fried by then or something. I don't know how many millions or billions of years it is from now, but...
Well, you and I don't have to worry about it.
Right.
Oh, that's good. Wow. I got enough to worry about without that.
Well, yeah, with evolution, there's going to be robots by then. They're going to be dealing with it.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, you concentrate on the mystery from non-life to life. You know, from an evolutionary perspective, I see that, you know, everything came from the Big Bang. You know, there's just pure energy, then there's matter came, and then from matter, life arose, biological life. And I also sincerely believe, and you can call it my religion if you want to, that this biological life is going to give rise to artificial life, and we're going to have artificial intelligence that's going to be the next stage. I mean, it may be 1,000 years, a million years, whatever, but it's going to be superior to our life, and we're going to be little pets for them because they're going to be superior.
All right. I hope you enjoy that.
As long as the religious people don't cause a nuclear war and kill each other or something like that, kill the evildoers, all that stuff.
Yeah. All the wars are based on religious people. Is it our fault for everything now?
Yeah. You agree with me, right?
Huh?
You agree with that, right?
No, sir, I do not. There's certainly some have been.
Just kidding there. Yeah. Okay, so our last segment, do you have anything you want to finish up on? This is a few seconds to summarize this section.
No, on my seminar part 7, my question answer, I give a long explanation of the red shift and what causes it. And I think I'm pretty, being a physics teacher and an earth science teacher, I'm probably more familiar than average person on the street about what causes these things. And so I give a reasonable explanation at a simplified level of what causes it. And quite a few quotes from major brand name evolutionists that would, I think, disagree, that we don't really know as much as they claim we know about all these things. And we certainly can't measure the distance to these stars. It just cannot be done. You know, you can't get two guys on your roof and measure the distance to Chicago just, you know, looking at do two telescopes and calculating the angle of out of parallel they are. It's too, the angle's too slight. Mm-hmm. Probably 100 light years is the most they can actually measure. The rest is inference. But yeah, that's all on my video number 7, which you can watch on Kent Hovind Official for free.
Do you have those on YouTube for free too yet? Or
but, what do you mean? Yeah, all YouTubes are free, aren't they?
No, I mean, you have it on YouTube? You said your website.
Yeah. All my stuff. Well, Kent Hovind Official is a YouTube channel. Yeah, all my stuff is up.
Sorry.
It's been for years.
Sorry about that.